straight edge.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a couple items. First, we signed, Governor signed the new budget yesterday, and there's money in there for lead services. I encourage everybody to call the governor's office and ask what we're getting to, because we need to replace these in favor. The next thing is the fire department and the DPW. Just last week, they just been swamped. All the cleanup, people are complaining they can't get their stuff cleaned up. It's a big city. It's a big city. The fire department was, we were without power for 5 days, house down the street going out. I think a 1900 farmhouse burned down, and they were there, and they busted their plans on that one. And then, I'm getting a lot of calls about the tax bills. What's going on? I used to be able to go on there and see last year's and this year's. Now it's just last year's. My tax bill for last year was $38.73. This year it's $41.74, but I wouldn't have known that. Because it's not on the website. Is that gonna happen soon, or what?
It was $38.73.
Wouldn't you have gotten that in the mail?
No, if their mortgage company has requested their bill, they do not receive an actual bill through the mail. And there have been quite a few calls regarding that. Some of the people are bringing in their 22 bills, paying their 22 bill, which is less than their 23 bill, because they're not realizing. It clearly says on the website it's the 22 bill, but they're just expecting that to be the 23 bill instead. So there's lots of payments that are coming up short. In the past, these have been online, and we've trained our residents very well, you know, to go on there, to look it up, to print it off, and they're not up there yet. So I've been told that they're...
Do we have any idea why?
Through the chair, I'll have to get with IT.
Yeah, get with IT.
That's all.
Well, in the being transparent, there are a number of things that were on the old website and that we've talked about that were IT threats. They were developed in-house. So the Taylor portal, iCare Taylor app, that's was one of the issues. It was a potential backdoor into our system, and I believe also the property tax record. So I believe what the treasurer worked out with IT was to simply post, to come up with a different way of doing it. But certainly, I think right after the last meeting, I know I received my bill.
And that has been an issue for many residents. I know that I just received my bill yesterday.
Wow.
And we mailed them out July 8th, I believe. So that's an issue too.
Yeah.
This is 2023. I should be able to go in there and see 2023.
I don't disagree with you. I have to have that follow-up in terms of where it stands. But they are due at the end of September, correct?
September 30th, yeah.
September 30th. I may have broken the record. I may have gotten the tax paid to you before you got your own bill.
A chance for that.
All right. Any further discussions on taxes? I'm sorry. For those that aren't aware, the taxes will have gone up 5% from last year's taxes. So Headley says that the taxes cannot go up greater than the rate of inflation or 5%, whichever is less. Historically, I don't know of any time where we've gone to 5% or above. It's been capped at 2, 3% this year. When we went through the budget, the rate of inflation was approximately 6 to 7%, maybe closer to 7%. And due to Headley, the rate of the tax increases could only go up by 5%. So people, this will be the first bill they receive that they will see that increase. Any further open business from the council?
Chairman.
Mr. Councilman Brandon, and then we'll go to Councilman Brown.
I had gotten communication from a resident, Pablo Van Morgan.
not those comments, there was some individuals from Dearborn Heights that wanted a traffic light put on Van Bourne, and Van Bourne is a county road. I did explain to them the selection of that site for an elementary school on a major road probably wasn't the best location. That's why we're, what's that?
Just like down the street.
Yep. It's, when you have them on five-lane roads and they're elementaries, and they don't put in enough parking for the school, yeah, there's a reason why the Taylor School District didn't put schools in the same locations as some of these other schools are placed. Poses an issue when you got a five-lane road, certainly there are issues. Any other open business from the council? Mr. Redd?
Chair. Just something pretty good here. Famous Dave's on August 26th, which is a Saturday from noon to 4 p.m. They're going to have a big cook-off. Some of the country's biggest outdoor cooks that cook barbecue will be there. The important thing is everything is free. Everything will be free. Food, drinks will be free on that day. Everybody's invited. Anybody that would like to attend, there will be more information coming in reference to this event. So we will be basically waiting to get additional, and if, as soon as I get it or the mayor's office gets it, we will make sure that it gets up. The second item I have.
Can I just add to that? Famous Dave's over the past 20, 25 years since they've been in this community, just most recently when they had the everything over at the high school, you know, they were there feeding everybody. They really have been a great community partner. So I appreciate you bringing that up here this evening. Councilman, you had another item?
Through the chair, the next item I have is I've been receiving just a couple of calls in reference to Airbnbs in our community. Now, Airbnbs, I called and checked with the ordinance department, and I checked with our people there. Our ordinance doesn't protect us from Airbnbs because it falls under basically a short-term lease. And what is happening is right now I have found 7 locations already in this city that are Airbnbs. They're not registered with us, they're not paying taxes, and even some of them are claiming that they're basically homesteads, which they can't be. And what's happening is, these are some of my concerns that have been concerns through other locations here in the state also. And this would possibly add additional traffic nuisance and public safety issues. They also add additional costs for inspections and code enforcement, which would be a strain on public resources that are stretched to the limits now. They should be paying lodge taxes, tourism tax to supplement the municipality. Unintended consequences of the decline in population, school enrollment, quality of life for the residents in those areas. This occurred in New Buffalo, Michigan, per its mayor. And as I discussed with one of our attorneys today, that he said that he had already gotten some calls also, and that there is nothing to protect these people from opening up these businesses. They can have as many people they want to come in there overnight. They can have their parties there. Plus, what they're doing is, this will become an issue of they'll be all over the city, and we can't track them. The only reason I've been able to find them will be able to track them in certain manners. But they're here already, and I've already had complaints from people that are taking up parking spots on their streets. The cars are parking in the driveway. These people are staying for 1 or 2 days. There's sometimes large numbers of people staying in these locations. And I just think that it might, as far as the state goes, there's no law that even protect us from the state. The state never set up a law to protect on the Airbnbs. And they are growing at a rapid number throughout the state. And again, they're not even registered with a business. And they should be registered as a business paying taxes or additional taxes that they should be paying, just like they would be if there were a hotel, a motel, whatever they may be. So what I'm recommending, this council give it a lot of thought, and I'd like to make a motion to this. I'd like to make a motion
I was gonna remind the council, it always helps as if you didn't write out. So give me a moment and I'll restate what I believe the councilman's intent was. And then I'll ask for support. Motion to direct the corporation council to research